भवतु सहनाहुनतु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः ॐ भूर्भुवस्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात् त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धु च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्याद्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव सो we will go to we did 29 last time right so the last verse just to connect was in verse 29 krishna bhagwan said the english translation it is the mind harmonized by yoga he sees the self abiding in all beings and all being abiding in the self he sees the same everywhere So this is like a test of somebody who got self-realized in meditation and the practices they are doing. So the next one is 30. So let's chant that. Yo mam pashyati sarvatra.
Yo mam pashyati sarvatra.
Sarvam cha mayi pashyati.
Sarvam cha mayi pashyati.
तस्याहं न प्रणश्यामि
तस्याहं न प्रणश्यामि
न च मे न प्रणश्यति
मे न प्रणश्यति
अच्छा आपके पास भी है ना उसको बुक सो रीड दैट संस्कृत देन
यो मींस हू Mama is me, Mama means we, Pashyati means sees, Sarvatra is everywhere, Sarvaya, all, Cha is and Mayi in me, Pashyati is sees, Tasya is of him, Aham is I, Na is not, Pashyami is vanish,
Pranashyami
is vanish, Sa is he, Cha and Me is to me, Na is not, Pranashyati is again vanishes. He who sees me everywhere and sees everything in me, he never gets separated from me, nor do I get separated from him.
So it's a two-way thing yeah. over here. Who sees me in everywhere. So everywhere and see everything in me. That's what I was last time talking about, that yoga and vibhuti. Both of them, both ways.
Mm-hmm.
So what happens when that happens? He never gets separated from me, nor do I get separated from him. So, वो merging का और भी उन्होंने खुल के बताया है, but you will see
what. Yeah, what they're trying to say is, if you're seeing God everywhere, then God is also seeing you or looking after you all the time. So
that's one way.
क्योंकि तुम उसके साथ एकदम एक हो
गए, एक हो गए, एक
हो गए ना, तो वो oneness का जो तुमको feeling है, it's in everything.
दोनों तरफ से है.
Drive कर रहे हो तो तुम scenery देख रहे हो तो तुमको लगता है कि कैसे भगवान ही फैल गया है यू नो मतलब एवरीथिंग यू एक्सपीरियंस यू बिगिन टू स्टार्ट एक्सपीरियंसिंग दैट वननेस
एंड देन यू विल सी दैट व्हेन द एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड आई ब्रॉट दिस ईशावासी आल्सो बिकॉज़ ही मेंशंस दैट वन वर्ड एंड दैट इज वेरी पावरफुल वर्ड एंड ही इज गोना टॉक अबाउट इट एंड आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इट इज बट हियर लेट्स रीड दिस सो यू कैन स्टार्ट यू वांट टू
Yeah, earlier we were told that on reaching his goal, the meditator attains infinite bliss of the Brahman contact. We explained therein that the term contact indicates, by a kindly suggestion, only the non-dual reality. which is the theme of all the Upanishads. Here in this stanza, we have Krishna's own commentary upon the term used in a couple of early stanzas. Once having awakened to the self, the perfect master therefore recognizes everywhere nothing but the self. He who sees me in all things and sees all things in me. In this stanza, as everywhere else, the first person singular I and me is to be understood as the self.
So this is very important. When Krishna Bhagwan saying seeing in me, he doesn't mean his Krishna Bhagwan, his body. That everybody knows, right? I'm not sure if something is confusing or
no.
It's okay. Yeah, because I don't know everybody's background. So he's just reminding that don't think it's talking about the self, the Atman, the Brahman he's talking about, that's all.
The I and the me is to be understood as the self. On rereading the stanza in the light of this annotation, this stanza and the previous one together express more fully the pregnant meaning of one of the famous Upanishadic declarations found in the Ishavasya. The second line of the Gita verse now under review is almost a commentary upon the last word in the Upanishad mantra referred above. Now, Viju Gupta Satya.
So it's called, the word is a little bit difficult to pronounce. Viju Gupta Satya. So what that word means is, then he doesn't hate anything.
No.
It's like our own body, agar usme kuch gadbad bhi ho jaye, so how we are compassionate to it? You know, kuch ghaav bhi ho jaye, kuch bhi ho jaye. So they see the whole world like that. तो अगर किसी ने कुछ गलत किया तो उसको वो हेट्रेड नहीं आती. हम लोग में क्या होता है, इमीडिएटली वी जज एंड हेट. एंड देन द रीज़न आई ब्रॉट दैट बिकॉज़ स्वामी जी हैड दिस सो मेनी नाइस वर्ड्स कि क्या क्या चीज़ हमारे अंदर होती है. सो इन हिज कमेंट्री इन ईशावास्य ही सेज, इन रियलाइजिंग दस मीनिंग दैट वननेस, आई एम नॉट रीडिंग द होल थिंग बिकॉज इट्स इट टॉक्स अबाउट दैट यू नो सेम कॉन्सेप्ट की जब वननेस हो जाता है, ऑल द मेंटल आइडिया ऑफ रिपल्शन, श्रिंकिंग, dislike, fear, hatred, and such other perversions of feelings. These arise from a sense of division and plurality. When you think of somebody is different, then you have these feelings. And consequent personal sense of opposition to other beings or objects around us. When all hatred, that's jugupsa, that's the Sanskrit word, hatred ko jugupsa, had dried away from the mind, the individual experience an unbroken sense of tranquility thereafter in all types of circumstances, favorable or unfavorable, in the language of the world. So that's what it means. That we
actually, the ego is dissolving and just, you know,
iski jo baat kar rahe na wo pura dissolve ho gaya uska, kyunki agar zara sa bhi trace hota hai na ego ka, fir wo feeling aana shuru ho jati hai. So he's talking about a man of realization, highest attainment.
Your eye is gone and it's just merged with the me, so there's no
eye
at all. So when there's no eye,
exactly, so isko wo kisko hate karega wo, you know. So jaise ki on a different level, when we think somebody is mine or our family or friends, we are a lot more compassionate towards them. Agar kuch gadbad bhi karte hai to usko hum prem se suljhane ki koshish karte hain. Koi aur karega to maro kaato usko, you know. So because we feel, so the more we feel oneness, the more we feel the love and we want to,
and we feel tranquility,
compassion. Yes, so everybody I think got it right. I thought this word is very powerful, you know. I can't even see it. I have
He never becomes separated from me. On transcending the intellect, the experience of the ego is not that it sees or perceives or cognizes the eternal, but the ego rediscovers itself to be, in its essence, nothing but self. Shivam.
Shivoham.
Shivoham. Mm. The dreamer, on awakening himself, becomes awaker. A dreamer can never see or recognize the waker as separate from himself.
So now he's just opening up in all different ways. What does it mean that he never becomes separate from me? So he's just saying that it's not like he attained something different. He realizes ego discovers itself to be in essence nothing but the self. Wo khud ko usko samajh mein aa gaya ki kuch hai nahi aur. मैं उसी की परछाई बोल दो मैं वही हूँ राइट एंड देन द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल इज ऑफ द ड्रीमर सो वेन वी ड्रीम एंड वेन वी वेक अप व्हाट डू वी से वॉज अ ड्रीमर समबडी डिफरेंट
नो
थिंक अबाउट इट वॉज नॉट I was dreaming myself. Now I have become the waker. So what happened? Dream just merged in me. It came out of me and it merged back into. So I was thinking ये जो आपको जो confusion हो रहा था ना mortality और immortality का इससे clear हो जाएगा कि all it was saying कि वो mortal immortal नहीं बन सकता और वगैरह वगैरह because it's not that the person has changed. He is just that dream appeared in him and again dissolved in him.
I wouldn't call it dissolved in him. Mortal is again immortal. Immortal is the soul and the body.
No. Mm-hmm. What I'm trying to say. See, this is the kind of thing that you have to just take the gist and drop the words. Otherwise, mm-hmm. you will be hanging on to the word.
Yeah.
All it's saying is that whatever you see in this world, it is an appearance, but it is because of God only. That's all it's saying. Mm-hmm. So, koi dusra nahi aa gaya wahan se. Everybody looking a little confused.
No.
You're getting it, right?
Oh, I'm getting it. The only, yeah. It is, you know, jab wo batate hain ki this is a dream world, right?
Yeah.
So then when you waken up.
You waken to the higher
to
self.
To the higher, then this too is a part of it, just like the dream.
Dream
here.
Is yeah. part of it. That's
part
what
of
it is.
Maya,
so that's what you're
the
saying.
World is
so
a Maya.
That dream and you, the waker, are same. When you, you know, wake up to the higher state.
Yeah.
This is a part of your dream
Dreaming.
And it's not any different.
Different.
Then.
Now
yeah.
she explained it good. Yes. So that's
right.
how it is. The connection
that's,
is there.
That's where the connection
yeah.
is there.
So.
And, you know, all along when I was reading, I felt the 28th, 29th, when he said the first one was, you know, first one, he recognizes himself to be that self. 29th, he sees the world.
So.
But there is still the I. And the you. Here he clarifies there is no I
and
you.
You.
Mm-hmm. It's me alone. The 30th says very clearly it's just me.
Yes.
There's nothing else yeah. besides.
And
me.
All the Upanishads they use slightly different language, but they're talking
about
exactly the same thing. And I will just tell you this ye jo ayana verse. Let me just give you the English translation of that verse. It's in verse 6. Isme thoda galat aa gaya wo 4 likha hua hai but it's the sixth vijuk sukte jo word tha na. So the translation is he who constantly sees everywhere all existent in the self and the self in all beings and forms thereafter feels no hatred for anyone. That is the verse of from Ishavasya number 6. It's exactly same thing, right?
Yeah.
कि एक बार उसको oneness हो गई तो वो hatred उसके रहा ही नहीं, उसके trace ही नहीं रहा उसका hatred उसके मन में. Okay, so I think that we got some clarification, right? Yes. Go ahead. आपको पढ़ना है किसी और को पढ़ना है?
I also want to understand this shivoham, like
shivoham. Shivoham is nothing but मैं शिव हूँ. अहम शिवो.
I am the auspicious.
Auspiciousness or Shiva ka matlab auspiciousness. In fact, everybody used to talk about that Devo ke Dev Mahadev
yeah,
series
yes.
and we just got this hotstar.com. So I started watching it and it begins with the whole thing begins with ki wo Daksh Prajapati jo tha na, he only wants to worship Vishnu. He says Shiva, wo to ami hai, you know. You have to take everything in totality. How can you take creation you know bolte hain ki maintenance and then dissolution ke bina creation ho hi nahi sakta so you are denying half of divinity
yeah
that's what he was doing he was just taking one part of it and then so then that problem started happening and I was just thinking about it for that purpose when we make have a friend or a relative or anybody that person is like a full personality usme koi cheeze hame uski achhi bhi lagti hai aur koi buri bhi lagti hai theek hai ki nahi लेकिन हम ये नहीं कह सकते कि मैं आई एम गोइंग टू लव मंजू बट ओनली हर गुड स्टफ आई गॉट टू लव मंजू एज शी इज
बट यू नो यू डोंट सी व्हेन यू लव समबडी यू डोंट सी
इफ यू ट्रूली लव समबडी
यू लव इट जस्ट और इवन इफ यू सी इट जस्ट लाइक अ माइनर थिंग ओके
I know, but we cannot divide a person. We
yeah,
cannot
we can.
divide. It's a coin.
As is.
I can I take the coin just half of it? I just want one side of the coin. Impossible.
Yeah.
When I pick up the coin, I gotta pick up the whole. That's what it is. That's
yes.
what they are pointing
yeah.
to.
Yeah.
यू नो बिकॉज व्हेन यू से होल वर्ल्ड, बिकॉज वो बोलेगा ओ ये खराब खराब चीज़ें कैसे हो सकती है भगवान, टोटैलिटी में वो है, यू नो
it is show in 11th chapter
John, yes it, and he even says that among what you call all these games I am main wo bhi hu kya usko bolte hain game of dice hindi mein kya bolte hain usko jyut bolte hain jua khelte jo jaise krishna bhagwan declares that main usme jua bhi hu chalon mein main jua hu
In everything is the essence.
Essence, it, exactly. That's so good, bad, you know, neutral, everything. Yeah. You know.
But I really think that one has to first start with the self and say that, you know, I have good things and I have bad things.
Yeah.
And if you first accept the bad things in you, then you'll understand that there's the same mixture would be probably in another.
Yeah, that's kind of compassion. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
That okay, you know, like I'm myself not perfect, so why am I expecting the rest of the world to be?
That but can how many of them have of us have attained that? I have not attained that.
We are on the path. Yeah, we won't. We are the reason we are. This is what it is. He's just showing you the goal. That how these people behave, what is their mind
they
and everything.
Master.
Yeah, real. So we can have some. Kya bolna chahiye, ideal to look at and try to be like them. That's all it is. It's not that we are there. We are all on the path.
Take a long time to get there.
Continue.
I said it'll take a long time.
It's okay. We just it's like if you are on the right path, one day we'll reach. That's all it is. We have to make sure. That's why all these guidance is there from the shastras.
Mm.
You know, otherwise we can just. But that's all it is.
You want to read?
Okay, so I'll go back.
Nor do I become separate from him. That's where I read, right?
Mm.
Is that the one?
Mm.
Yeah.
The dualists are rather hesitant to accept that infinite divinity is their real nature, for they are, as ego-centers, conscious of their own bodily vanities and sins. In no clearer terms can we move exhaustively describe the unadulterated truth of the essential divinity in man. Lord Krishna here is in no way trying to conceal his meaning that a meditator, when he has fulfilled the process of detachment from the not-self, himself becomes the eternal and the infinite. It may be a staggering truth, but all the same, it is the truth. Those who are hesitating and wavering may well continue to disbelieving their own divine potentialities. But the intimate experience of the long hierarchy of gurus in India and the mystic saints all over the world have endorsed this unbelievable plain truth that in essence, the self in an individual is the same self everywhere.
So he's again talking about that how dualist can never feel, oh, how can I be God? They always have that separation.
Mm.
You know, ki God is there, I am here. But he's just saying Lord Krishna himself is declaring here because in Bhagavad Gita, he's talked about everything. He's talked about duality and, you know, this here he's talking absolute non-dual. So he's saying that it is just completely the truth as it is, he's declared.
Sorry.
That's okay. And then he's also saying that this is the experience of all the hierarchy gurus. So hum usko deny nahi kar sakte ki this is the truth, that you yourself are that, because it has been verified by so many people for so many thousands and thousands of years. And they continue to. We have self-realized people constantly coming out of in India.
Mm.
And even elsewhere, you know, probably.
Yeah.
It's everywhere. So, but unka sabka experience wahi hai. That's what he's telling you to do. And if you think about it, Mandukya is saying the same thing. It's saying it even a little more forcefully.
Yeah.
Because it's denying everything else. Krishna Bhagwan is very kind. He's saying, acha, ye bhi theek hai, ye bhi theek. Final conclusion yehi hai, unka bhi.
Yeah.
Right?
Right,
agreed?
Right. Yeah, but there he, Godfather.
Godfather
very,
doesn't even want to
strict.
Go. Yeah, he doesn't want to go anywhere.
Yeah.
He
yeah.
just said that this is it, take it or leave it. Krishna Bhagwan is not, he's catering to everybody.
Yeah.
But he's saying in the end, yehi hai. and
eventually you will get to that.
Yes.
That's the
yes.
thing. That's what he's yeah. saying. At present, there is a divorce of ourselves from ourselves. The ego is a rebel who has exiled himself from his native kingdom, the self. On rediscovery of the self, the ego becomes the self. In such a happy blending of homogeneous whole that thereafter there is no distinction between the ego and the self. On awakening, the dreamer becomes the waker. Not only does the dreamer become the waker, but the waker can never remain separate from the dreamer. In ordinary divorces, either of the party can divorce the other, and yet the divorced can still maintain an emotional relationship with the one who had separated and gone away. Here, the Lord says that not only does the seeker comes to feel the selfhood, but I, the self, become homogeneously one with him.
So he's just again hammering it. There's no difference.
In me, yeah.
Yes.
The Lord.
And I think the one good example is if there is like a नदी जब सागर में मिलती है तो सागर में मिलने के बाद वो नदी नहीं रह जाती एंड यू कैन नॉट सेपरेट गंगा वेंस एंड वंस इनटू गंगा सागर नोबडी कैन से कि ये इस पानी में से सेपरेट करो कौन सा गंगा है कौन सा यू कैन नॉट डू इट फिनिश्ड इट्स डन वन दैट्स व्हाट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट
इन फैक्ट वंस वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट मिसगाइडेड गॉड इज अ मैन इट बिकम्स एम्पली क्लियर दैट राइटली गाइडेड मैन rediscovers himself to be nothing other than the supreme. And an actor playing the part of a beggar is not really a beggar, and the moment he drops down the part he's playing, he becomes what factually he is. In fact, even while he was playing his role, he was not a beggar. This daring declaration of Vedanta in itself is not at all difficult to understand, but the deluded feels terribly aghast at this revelation, and in their imperfections, they refuse to believe this truth. They have not the guts to take the responsibilities of living a godly life. Krishna's courageous statement in this stanza leaves not even a pinhole of a doubt to enter on this sacred conclusion of all the scriptures of the world, especially that of immortal Upanishads.
So I think how beautiful example he gave of this person who is playing a beggar. So wo sachmuch hai kya beggar wo?
Right.
Nahi hai.
Just an actor is just an actor, yeah.
Haan. To hum log ko lagta hai ki we are separate from God. He's saying you are not. And he's saying that jaise hi wo role khatam karta hai, wo wapis, actually mein wo tha hi nahi beggar. Sirf usko aisa lag bhi nahi raha tha, wo to act kar raha tha.
So, you know, we are immortal. That's
yes,
it.
That's it. That's
that
it.
We
yeah.
are. And we take mortality. We take, when we are doing this drama, we take ourselves to be that actor.
Because
and
we,
not
yes.
that
yeah.
we are, you know.
And once we separate the body and all that, we know that body is mortal.
Yeah.
So when talk about immortality, it's not the body. Body is going to go.
Yeah.
But in essence, we are immortal.
Immortal, mm-hmm. yes.
That's it. That's what its conclusion is, yes.
So how does this fit into the concept of reincarnation?
So that was another, I had put a note to myself because last time there was some confusion. So reincarnation, we have to understand it's a subtle body that moves to the next life. So we have different layers. So one is this gross body is made of five elements, so that even from Western point of view or science point of view, the five elements go back to the five elements. When somebody dies, it disintegrates, so jala do, kuch bhi kar do. And then the mind and intellect travels with all the impressions in it. So that's why when they say purify the mind, is when you take the birth in the next life, new body will be given to you. And in the end, the idea is even the subtle body has to dissolve for the self-realized person. But when we say ki kisi ko self-realization ho gaya, usko jivan mukt naam diya inhone. To matlab, he has gone beyond immortal, wo isliye ho gaya, because he does not, the way Swamiji explains is very good. He calls his mortality means change. Jo hamara constantly change hota hai na, wo hai mortality. Or immortal is no change. This person has risen above it. Usko change affect nahi karta. That's how we have to understand.
Immortal means then he won't take birth again. What do you say that?
I know, but I'm explaining ki Gita is saying don't wait until you die to become immortal. You become immortal now. So they will just drop the body, but then they will not take birth again. You're right. Mm-hmm. And if they want to take birth, it's like Krishna Bhagwan himself. He came because he wanted to. Or kisi ne ye example diya ki kisi ne ek factory banayi ho. Usme kuch gadbad chal raha hai to aayega ek din na owner usko dekhne ke liye, fix karne ke liye aayega. That's what the role of this avatars are. Avatars, they know, you know. That's why, you know, Krishna Bhagwan is like, it's a leela or jo bhi bol do. There are so many different words they use. So, you know, but for our understanding that even while we are in this body, you can get enlightened. And then another confusion that, because it's good that I'm recording it, because then I can go here. Enlightenment word, okay? That has nothing to do with a physical light. Enlightenment is same as moksha, nirvana, self-realization. Some people call it total freedom, realizing the truth, becoming a Brahman. Each line...
Merging with the God.
Yeah,
God.
But it is not... Our body is not merging. I'm realizing that I am that. That's called merging.
Yeah.
You know? And then not just intellectually. But that's why he gave that word that I think you missed it because you came late. There is one word that person feels no hatred. Yeah, you're right. That person feels no hatred towards anything or anyone. Just jo self realize ho jata hai na, uska wo vijuk sapa some word is there. It came from Ishavasya, that word.
That
dissolve ho jata hai uska.
Khatam ho jati hai, jaise uski ego khatam
hoti hai,
becomes part of Brahma.
He is Brahma.
Yeah,
Brahma. Because when you say Brahma, the world confusion like Brahma, Vishnu, Vishnu. That's the creator.
Yeah,
huh?
That's the creator.
Okay. Brahma. Okay. So I think everybody got the...
I'll just read one first stanza from my...
Yeah, sure.
This stanza of the Gita definitely points out that the illumined yogi does not lose the individuality of his soul. Instead, he finds his being extended into the being of the spirit. An ordinary person perceives himself as separate from God. The advanced yogi feels his soul as a wave in the ocean of cosmic consciousness.
Mm-hmm. It's very
nice. But the completely liberated yogi beholds his soul wave as a manifestation of the cosmic ocean. And such a yogi never says, I'm God, for he knows God can exist without his soul. But if he wants to, he can say, God has become myself.
Yeah, it's something like we talked about, that the wave is different from the sea. It's called a wave because it's connected with the ocean. If you take that water and put it here, it's not a wave anymore. Mm-hmm. It has to be part of it. So that's what it is. Okay, did we finish?
Yes.
Reading
finished,
this?
Yes.
Okay. So I think that all of us got it. It's hard to describe these things, but as long as you're internally getting it, that's what counts the most. Okay. Shall we go to the next one?
This last one is also good. Every man who leaves the earth in an embittered state of unrequited love has to come back here until he finds the perfect love of God.
Yeah, you can look at it that way, or they use different languages, but this is the hum log ka jo life ka goal hai, wo self-realization hi hai, magar humko pata hi nahi hai aur hum log duniya mein idhar udhar bhagte rehte hai. He's not saying don't achieve things in the world, but that's literally secondary.
Yeah.
You know?
So when he recognizes the Lord as the only perfect lover, his heart seeks no other affection. After many prodigal wanderings, the yogi meets the cosmic lover in the bower of eternity. Wherever the yogi turns his attention, he sees his beloved peeping at him through the windows of stars and flowers, through every opening in the atoms and the pores of the sky. The cosmic lover similarly beholds the lost and found soul of the yogi steadfastly looking at him. So that's why he's saying our main goal is to merge with God, and that's why we're taking rebirth again and again.
Right. That's exactly why we are here. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The next one is Sarva Bhuta Sthitam Yo Mam.
Sarva Bhuta Sthitam Yo Mam.
Bhajyati katva mastitaha,
bhajyati katva mastitaha,
सर्वथावर्तमानोऽपि
सर्वथावर्तमानोऽपि
सयोगीमयि वर्तते
सयोगीमयि वर्तते.
सुशील जी आप पढ़ेंगे. ओ संस्कृत का करना है ना. ओ दुर्गा जी कर सकती हैं संस्कृत.
सर्वभूतस्थितम् अबाइडिंग इन ऑल बीइंग्स यह हु माम मी भजते वर्शिप्स एकत्वम न यूनिटी
इन यूनिटी
आस्थितः एस्टैब्लिश्ड सर्वथा इन एवरी वे वर्तमानः रिमेनिंग अपि आल्सो सह दैट योगी योगी मई इन मे वर्तते अबाइड्स.
Now this particular shloka is very important for people like us. So let's see what he says.
He who, being established in unity, worships me, dwelling in all beings, that yogi abides in me, whatever be his mode of living.
The last part, whatever he be his mode of living, is the key thing, and you will see how he'll explain, huh?
The meditator who has integrated himself in a single pointedness steadily contemplates this
bhajati.
Steadily contemplates upon me the self, which is the essential spark of life in all forms in the world. Such an individual, whatever be his activities in the external world, ever lives in me through a conscious awareness of the self. This stanza is given here mainly to indicate that the man of realization need not necessarily retire to some secret cave in some forgotten valley of the Himalayas, but can maintain his divine consciousness in all states of existence, in all conditions of life, and under all happy or unhappy circumstances. When a man is ill, he has to withdraw himself from the fields of activities, strains, and exhausting recreations, and go to sanatorium to recuperate. Having regained his natural health, he need not thereafter live forever in the sanatorium. On the other hand, he should come back to his old fields of work and live perhaps a more active life than ever before.
So everybody understood what he's trying to say over here? That जो भी कुछ कर रहा है और वो दुनिया की नज़र से वो अनहैप्पी हैप्पी सरकमस्टेंसेज हो सकता है, बिकॉज हम लोग बहुत जल्दी जज करते हैं, ओ वो बेचारा और समथिंग लाइक दैट. समटाइम दोज बेचारा पीपल आर मोर बैलेंस्ड इन देयर हेड देन अस हू आर गॉट एवरीथिंग. सो दैट्स व्हाट ही इज सेइंग. सो ही इज सेइंग दैट डज नॉट मैटर वेयर यू आर, व्हाट ही डज नॉट लूज दैट कनेक्शन विद द सेल्फ, एंड दैट्स व्हाट ही इज सेइंग. एंड देन हियर ही इज सेइंग दैट and maintain the divine consciousness all states of existence in all conditions of life, under happy or unhappy circumstances. So that does not matter at all. That's what it is. We very quickly judge, or we think, oh, we will do something else and I can connect to God better, or I do this and I know. He's saying it has nothing to do with it. This is some internal journey. And you can be in whatever.
So he's 24 hour. He's in sort of meditation.
Yeah.
Or he has that vision.
He has that connection.
It's not like for just in meditation.
But more than that we sometimes get
in every whatever he's doing.
Whatever he's doing. But one of the point that I wanted to bring over here, because hum log bahut wo ho jate hain na, hai main kya karun ab to go in this path.
Yeah.
Right. So. Like you were saying it, even when you're cooking, you can be connected to God. Even when you're doing, somebody said that Shabri was doing a jhadu for the whole year, and that became her puja and her sadhana, and you know,
waiting for,
and all she did was jhadu, but because she had Ram in her mind, that became, so that's what it is.
Like India, mein bhi Sadhguru ek apne lecture mein bol rahe the ki there are so many women, you know, wo apne ghar ke usme उनको ठीक से जीना आता है तो वो कैसे
बैलेंस होती है
एकदम तृप्त हो करके दे कैन हैंडल एवरी सिचुएशन सो वेल.
यस आई एग्री.
आई मीन समटाइम्स यू मीट ऑर्डिनरी पीपल एंड दे आर
टोटली बैलेंस्ड. यस उनको कुछ मतलब उनके balanced mind, unruffled, perturbed by small, stupid things, you know, that we get so upset over and all that, yeah.
Similarly, a disintegrated man of unhealthy temperament is, in spiritual life, treated through meditation, and when he regains his godly strength and vitality, he can certainly re-enter the fields of his earlier activity, and yet maintain in himself the cultural perfection and spiritual knowledge of that. He has gained during his spiritual treatment.
So I just wanted to bring one point here. Somebody wrote that before realization, I was taking out water from the well, and after realization, I'm doing the same thing. Mm. So he just said, you don't need to change your activity. And he's even saying that, okay, you agar koi gaya bhi hai meditate karne ke liye, they can come back to the same activity and do it, you know, but it'll be a different attitude this time. That's all.
Look at our Gurudev ji. He left, you know, what he was a journalist.
Mm.
And then he went up for a few years, he got it, he came back and did more for the
Yeah, he did.
Yeah.
Yes.
So
exactly.
He's our best example.
I mean Vivekananda is the same.
Yeah.
And unke jo master hote hai na, वो उनको मालूम होता है कि that's the काम उनसे करवाना
है.
Yeah, yeah, because they groom them to go and do those things. To do jan seva, you know.
Work, in fact, can be performed and really enduring fruits.
Different.
It was only
Maybe somebody, because all of us have the same book, you have slightly different. It's the same, but it's me kuch different ang se
diya. So,
who wants to read?
Comes with same thing. So
that's fine. Let him
read.
Yeah.
That's fine. It's okay.
Because everybody has this one. That's why.
So you
I was
can
saying.
Read that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Open that door more.
Why? You want me to read?
Yeah, read it. Because he is slightly different.
Achha, okay. Mm. It was only a mischievous understanding that has not been debilitated, brought into the Hindu tradition, thought by the saboteurs of our culture, that had perverted the noble Hindu idealism. There is a very unhealthy tendency among us to believe and preach that spiritual self-realization is a death knell to all activities. Had it been true, we would not have been discussing now this very textbook, which is the noble labor of a man of serialization, Vyas, reportingly the wisdom of the divine personality. Work, in fact, can be performed and really enduring fruits can be gained only when the worker has got himself established in the self. The labor of the Gita is to advise Arjun that dedicated work is a means of self-development.
So he's just saying that how we have this idea that, you know, person who has become self-realized, wo gufa mein chala jayega, kuch karega nahi, ye wo. So he's just saying that agar ye baat hoti to we wouldn't be reading this Bhagavad Gita, because there he's telling him ki usko bol raha hai ki tu war kar, fight kar, and then that is a means of your self-realization. Wo to extreme ho gaya na. He has
no,
to
war
kill.
Kar, but with what attitude? That's the
mind.
That's the important thing. That's
exactly
what he taught him.
What, without
attitude.
Attachment, without all this, for the welfare of people
right.
And all that, exactly.
And that's what
continue.
In the same Gita, there is a deeper significance in the fact that Krishna, the perfect, is also on the battlefield, exposing himself perhaps more to the dangers of the battle than Prince Arjun himself. A charioteer meets the arrows earlier than the warrior who stands behind him.
We never thought about that.
Yeah, we never thought about that.
Yeah. Yes, he's in before even Arjun is standing.
And he's unarmed, the charioteer.
Yeah, he's
going
to say that. So, dekho, aage badho.
A charioteer meets the arrows earlier than the warrior who stands behind him. Entering a battlefield armed with nothing but his irresistible smile and in effect becoming himself almost the uncrowned lord of the battlefield, wherein the entire war, as it were, comes to revolve around Krishna, the central personality.
This means that a man of realization will in all conditions be able to enter into any activity and still maintain in himself the unbroken awareness of the divine that he is. While reading the commentary, some students might feel that we are bringing an overemphasis in our over-enthusiasm, reading a bit too much into the stanza. We can only request them to ponder for themselves over the comprehensiveness of the words used in the daring statement. Whatever his mode of life be,
sarvartamanopi,
the meditator yogi abides in me.
So he's emphasizing that key, whatever the mode be, he abides in me. But this is such an interesting fact they brought about Krishna, that he's standing in before Arjun in the battlefield without any weapons, just with a smile. But because of his, he's so established
smile
in that self. Yeah. सही बात है, बिल्कुल सही।
बहुत डिफिकल्ट है, कहना और पढ़ना आसान है, पर कोई अगर गाली दे रहा है, डांट रहा है, तो आप स्माइल करते रहे।
हम लोग एक्सपेरिमेंट कर सकते हैं, है ना? नेक्स्ट टाइम पे कोई गाली वाली दे रहा है तो स्माइल करो।
स्माइल करेगा तो दूसरे को और भी गुस्सा आएगा कि तुम लोग कितना यू नो
लाफ कर रहे हो मेरे
पर। आई थिंक चुप रहो तो एटलीस्ट 2 and 2 won't make 4। Two and zero will remain to two.
But that famous story of a Buddha, I don't know, you did I?
Yeah.
I must have said it. Yeah, all of you know, na?
In that Buddha series, it was so beautiful.
Yeah, but इसमें वो आदमी गाली दे रहा था बुद्धा को.
हाँ.
ये वाले पता नहीं उसमें थी या नहीं, but it's just a very दृष्टांत है एक बस कि वो गाली दे रहा था बुद्धा को और बुद्धा को कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ा. बुद्धा smile करते जा रहे हैं, smile करते जा रहे हैं. तो वो घर गया, इतना उसने गाली दी कि उसका मुंह सूख गया, उसका थक गया वो बेचारा. तो वो जाके सो लेटा तो उसको नींद ही नहीं आया, उसको बुद्धा का चेहरा सामने आए, भाई मैं इतनी गाली दिया है, नहीं, he's just smiling. And then he went back and he said, Buddha, I don't care who you are, but just tell me that how you were so calm. So then he told him कि अगर तेरा पेट भरा हुआ हो एकदम और देखो कोई बहुत अच्छी मिठाई ला के देगा तो खाएगा? तो बोला नहीं, पेट भरा होगा तो नहीं खाऊंगा. कोई गंदी सी चीज़ ला के दे तो खाएगा? तो बोला नहीं. तो बोला वैसे ही मैं तृप्त हूँ, तो तू मेरे को गाली दे चाहे जाके मेरे को प्रेज कर, मैं मेरे को भी फर्क नहीं पड़ता, बिकॉज मेरे को चाहिए ही नहीं. आई एम जस्ट यू नो
दैट्स व्हाट आई प्रैक्टिस. कोई गुस्सा करता है इसकी प्रॉब्लम है, तू क्यों परेशान हो जा,
राइट,
मैं नहीं लूंगी,
राइट, इफ यू डोंट टेक इट,
होने दे इसको तो.
और किसी ने तो और भी एक स्टेप आगे की बात बोली,
पत्थर भी फेंक रहे
थे, ये बोला कि वो गाली दे रहा था जी मुझे, तो बोला दे ही रहा था ना, कुछ ले तो नहीं रहा था.
एक दफा हम वहाँ पे थे उसमें हरिद्वार में, तो हम अपने मदर के साथ गए, तो वो जो पंडित जी थे, किसी ने पूछा कि हमारे घर में बहुत खटपट रहती है हस्बैंड वाइफ में, तो आप बताइए मेरे को शांति कैसे मिलेगी. पहले तो वो बिल्कुल चुप हो गए, उसके बाद वो बोले कि तुम ऐसे करो कि एक सोने की तीली बना लो, वो सोने की तीली अपने मुंह में डाल लो, जैसे ही वो होगा प्रॉब्लम स्टार्ट हो जाता है, मुंह में तीली डाल लो और उसको गिरने ही नहीं देना उनसे.
तो वो नहीं पाएगा. It's so beautiful.
That was all he said.
Because that's like it's a very practical thing.
खोलेगा नहीं
तो problem क्या होगा? बोलते ना ताली तो दो हाथ से बजती है, you know? So अगर कोई चिल्ला रहा है कुछ कर रहा है,
okay. उसको करेंगे इसलिए.
Oh yes.
ऐसे वो बुद्धा को भी I think some